If you run a Facebook group in 2020, it's important to look at the group settings. Who's allowed to post to the group? Who approves the posts to the group? Various things you can set up here, and I'll show you how in this video. Here we go. So here I am in my free social media training group, and if I click here on more, and then select edit group settings, that brings up all the settings I can now go through. So we've already talked before about the name of the group and how you can change that and the type of group. It may be worth checking to see if there's a new option that suits better. But work-related ones are probably the only types that have been added in recent times. Add to the description potential benefits of joining the group. You can have a location. You can have 4 or 5 tags. People who are looking for similar types of groups may find this one. There are various apps you could offer. Which pages the pages associate the group is associated with. So this one's linked to PR Wilson Media, and that's created this group. Choose a color, that's fairly straightforward. Probably the big change now is in the previous iterations of Facebook groups, there was private, public, and secret groups. Now there's just public or private. And basically, if you were to select change privacy now and change between public to private, that would effectively be the last time you'd be able to then make it public again, because it's a one-way street. Now you can start private and make it public, that's fine. But if you start public, make it private, you can't go back to being public again. It's all to do with the permissions and what users have granted you. By joining as a private group, you can't suddenly change the game. And that links in with whether the group can be hidden or not. If it's public, it's very visible. Membership badges to encourage participation. You can manage these. Allocate people certain roles or badges within the group. So new member gets to be shown for 2 weeks once someone's joined. Once they've been there for a while. The only other ones there are moderator and admin. It's useful to have additional moderators in a group to make sure they control some of it, reinforce the rules of the group and that sort of thing. So that's a fairly new feature, the member badge. Post topics. Again, that depends whether you've got the topics feature enabled. Not everybody does, but you can have. Why wouldn't you enable it? It really makes it categorize everything that's being used in the group. You can add a section on mentorship if you want. So somebody can share their specific knowledge and work with people. And depending on the nature of the job, you could add jobs. If it's that kind of group, social learning units, you can enable that as I've done. And you can add these in little videos and sections of the page where people can access all the things in one area. So it's a useful feature for a training type of group. And you can add or remove that. And in terms of approval, this is quite important. Do you let people approve membership if they're your friends in the group? But I would suggest only admins and moderators. It makes it a lot easier to keep control of who joins the group. Asking questions is a standard practice as well. So I have 3 questions set up that help people explain why they want to join. And yes, it's possible to automatically approve certain members in advance and even from other groups. Now, membership requests from pages. So if you don't want your group to include pages as well, you can actually simply say, don't allow them to join as group members. Well, I think it's good to open it up. Some people don't like to have to be their personal profile just to join in. So it's a good thing, I think, to have allow pages to join. And posting permission is very important. Are you just going to talk to the group and nobody else can post? They can comment, etc. Then you'd say only admins. Otherwise, anyone in the group can join. And post approval, Do you want everything to just go out unvetted, or do you want to first be told that the post's been made and then approve it? I think it's better that way, again, to keep control of the group. Okay, so let's have a look now with the newer 2020 version of the interface. So we'll go to switch to that area. And the difference here is that you've got tabs all set up already, and you can just edit them individually. So you can edit the privacy section, public or private, hide group. Again, it's same as before. You can't actually select that one. It's grayed out if you're a public group anyway. So I'll say cancel there. And all the same headings are there, badges. The group features, being able to add the membership, who is pre-approved to join. So it's just a different layout coming through. And if there's something that's not there currently in this version, you can always switch back to classic Facebook there. So that's the group settings you need to look at in 2020. I'm Paul from PR Wilson Media, your social media personal trainer. Cheers.